What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Here we are again, episode 30, my goodness, of My Career Mode with CM Puma. As you can see there at the top, it looks like we have a call-out promo before we face off Shinsuke Nakamura. We are in a rivalry with Hideo Itami, and I'm thinking, I don't know. I don't know what's, that's not what I wanted. Hideo was number one on the contenders list, but he's been since pushed down to number five. Sami Zayn is number one, and I'm about sick and tired of facing Sami Zayn. So we got Gentleman Jack on the list as a created friends created call there. Shinsuke is number two, Scott Dawson, Samoa Joe, and Hideo's there at number five. So looks like we have a call-out promo that the game set up for us. Now remember, you can't set up a promo. Well, that one says it, but you can't set up a promo if you're in a rivalry. So this one was set up for me. So let's get into it and see if we can get Hideo to come out. All right, here comes CM Puma. I wish they would make it to where you would come out with the title. If you're the champion, then you should be able to come out to these promos with the title and wear it either around your waist or try to have it around your shoulder. I mean, whatever, but I at least think you should have it on. All right, here we go. I'm not in the mood to play games right now, so let's get down to business. I've got something to say, and I'm not waiting a second longer to say it. Okay. Oh, whoops, that was an accident. Okay, Hideo, let's see. Oh, I don't want to call this guy a loser. Let's see, I don't want to say this guy I'm about to call out here is a loser, but let's say if this were the 1980s, you'd never hear his theme music because he'd already be in the ring when the show came back from commercial. He's just called that fool a jobber. You get the jobber's entrance. Let's fight tonight. So, if you all want to see it, I think that Hideo Itami and I should have ourselves a match right here tonight. So, let's see. Is he going to come out? Or are we going to talk a little bit more? Oh, okay. Okay, Hideo Itami is coming out to the ring. He's got his microphone in hand. Whoa. All right, let's get this going here. Let's see what Hideo has to say. You all know me and what I'm about. And you know I'm a lot of things. Oh, jeez, I can't read. But one thing I'm not is a coward. I stand up for what I believe in, and when someone wants to settle a score with me, I come out and settle it. Well, that's good, because I'm sick of your mouth. No one cares about you. Oh, you'll have to excuse me. You must have me confused with someone who cares about you or anything that you have to say. There's only one person out here who the WWE Universe wants to see, and that person is me. Okay. Come on, Hideo, what do you got to say about that? You aren't serious, are you? You know this is the WWE, right? Where real superstars compete against each other, the daycare center is down the street. I'll give them a call. Make sure they have plenty of soft toys for you when you get there. Look, he's not impressed. Do we have any abilities? Nope, we're going to have to buy some promo abilities. Let's see. Daycare, really funny. Figures you'd have the daycare center on your phone, considering that's where the majority of your fans can be found. Bottom line, I have what it takes to go the distance in this business, and I've proved it time and time again. We're kind of beating Hideo right now, but we need to step it up. You come out here every week, try to push your weight around, show off your clout, bully people. Well, maybe I should know better, and maybe I should mind my own business, but someone needs to put you in your place, and that someone is gonna be me. You know what, Hideo? I don't think so. You're not ready for this. Oh, right. You're not ready for this. While you're at it and where I'm at... Oh, jeez, I can't read. Where you're at and where I'm at, if you face me now, you're going to get destroyed. You're going to lose in a way... Why can't I read? What's happening? You're going to lose in a way that you can never recover from, and I don't want to do that to you. Actually, I do want to do that to him. I want to end this fool. I don't want to wait until the next pay-per-view. I don't care about fighting on a big stage or having a big, memorable match. I just want to fight you. I want to fight you now, here, in front of these people. I want them to see me kick your ass all around this ring. This is a family-friendly crowd we got here, Hideo. You think I'm afraid of you? Nice. You think I'm afraid to face you? There isn't an ounce of fear in my body. You just wait until we have our match. You're going to find out just what it's like to be utter humiliated in front of the world. Do we get the last word? Heck yeah. You're going to be sorry. Nice. You're going to be sorry you ever opened that big mouth of yours. Whether it happens in this ring or not, I'm going to get my hands on you. And when I do, be prepared to experience pain like you've never felt before.
Wow.
Well, CM Puma totally dominated that promo. There we go. We earned a drop the mic trophy. Just call me the next Enzo Amore. Here we go. We're going to be facing off against Shinsuke Nakamura. And once again, as the champion, we're coming out of the ring. That annoys me. Okay, we're just going to kind of skip through these. Can we? I wonder if we can break out during Shinsuke's entrance and just attack him. Although he does have a pretty cool entrance. Well, it won't let me break out, but we'll sit here and watch it for just a second. Maybe CM Puma needs a Shinsuke Nakamura entrance. That looks pretty cool. Maybe once we move up to the main roster and we're not facing him all the time. But let's get into our matchup here against Shinsuke. Okay. Come on, buddy. Let's do it.
You can feel the electricity.
And a European uppercut to start this match off with. Stomping away. And right away, CM Puma is just trying to show his dominance. Kick to the head. And, oh, look at that. We just did his own move on him. Get up. Sending Nakamura now across the ropes. Big knee to the face. I feel like we are going to be doing that often to this fool. Stand up, Shinsuke. Stand it up and turn around. Oh, no, not turning around. Drop kick, and we just barely got him. Just barely got him with that. Big chop. Oh, get off me. Can't handle this, boy. And a reversal from Shinsuke, and he gets us with a big running knee. Jeez. And now he's cranking the mask in the head of CM Puma. Shinsuke, you gotta do a little bit more than that, buddy. Oh. I mean, I didn't mean like right now. Knee to the lower back. That's probably one of my more favorite striking moves just because it's a pretty devastating move when you think about it. Right there in your kidneys. Puma stunner. Right there. Jungle stunner. I don't know what to call that move. I don't know what to call it. Off the top shooting star press, man. Puma is high flying. He is action for sure. And right now, why are you backing up, Puma? We're stuck. Jeez, we got stuck for a second. European uppercut. Big flying cross body, cross chop, whatever you want to call that. And I pushed the wrong button. It's going to send Nakamura across the ropes. Oh!
A textbook reversal.
Nice reversal there. And nice, we reversed him right back. Chopping, he's reversing this back and forth here. Too fast on that reversal. We don't get an option. Okay. Michinoku driver, but we're going to scoot out. That's going to save us a reversal. And into the barricade. Oh, chop to the face. Too late. And a second Michinoku driver, this time to the outside. Trying to roll us over here. And there's that knee to the lower back. And look at this. Got some Pentagon Jr. in him. As he tries to break the arm of CM Puma, I don't think so. Puma able to get him up. Hits him. Big kicks.
Nakamura is really starting
get into the ring.
I'd say he's starting to feel the pressure.
Okay,
a bit.
Stand him up.
Wow,
come on. Come on.
Point,
crowd wants to see it.
Away, which is what we might be seeing right now.
Here we go.
Now and then, it's okay
and that did not work out as planned at all. That was actually
right now,
quite terrible.
Times,
okay. Well, we're gonna taunt a little bit. You think
like
we can get him? Where are you going?
I don't like his entire face.
I'm just going to dive off, elbow to the back. And it looks like we hurt ourselves a little bit, but that's going to be okay, I think. Let's try this move again, this time when we're not backed up against the ropes and we got stuck. Onto one knee. And here we go. Off the second rope. Into a short Rana, I want to say they call that. Hopping over. Big leg drop across the chest. Yeah, boy. And we're gonna go ahead and hit him with that finisher. We're gonna hit him with the jungle stomp across the ring. Big face. I don't know what I'm saying. Face first into the ground there. And that can't be hit, right? Oh my gosh. That was a little unexpected. That was a little unexpected as he wasn't even close to being that damaged, but we got a 4-star match of it. That seems to be about our average, so let's move forward out into main event and see what's going on over there. Okay, so here on main event, we have a main event match with Samoa Joe, but it looks like Hideo Itami has a call out, so we'll see how that goes. Why can't I? Oh, let's move on to the card. I was trying to simulate, but let's move on to the main part of the card, and we can simulate this and see what Hideo Itami says. Here comes Hideo out with his microphone. Let's just get into it here and see what he has to say. I'd like to start with a brain teaser. How many authority members does it take to screw in a light bulb? Nobody knows. They're still working on it. I know. I'm rocking the boat by mocking them, but how else am I supposed to get their attention? I'm hands down the best guy on the roster, and it's about time I speak my mind and get noticed. Okay, we have that option to run in up there. Let me ask you guys something. Am I the best superstar in the WWE right now? And am I, beyond a shadow of a doubt, a main event player? Agreed. And yet, I continue to be ignored by the powers that be. That's going to come to an end right here, right now. I don't think so, Hideo. Mm-hmm. That's it. Don't come into my house and start mouthing off. We're going to take care of that as right now. Get into the ring, Puma. Here we go. Mic performance dictates a number of things you can do to a promo. If you get higher scores, take longer, or slow the timer during any given promo. So we did introduce a mic skill, so let's see. I couldn't stand back and listen to you. Oh, well, I'm sorry, but I couldn't stand back there and listen to you ramble on any longer. You're putting the WWE Universe to sleep, and that's not why they spent their hard-earned money to come here tonight. They came here tonight to see a fight, and who knows, maybe they're just going to see just that in a few minutes between me and you. But first, I need to get something straight. Okay, Dale? I'm sorry, can you speak a little louder? I was too busy listening to this electric crowd to understand the whiny dribbles spilling out of your mouth. Seriously, it sounds like an orchestra of dogs singing for a bone. Come on, say your piece, and let's get this over with already, you jerk. Let's see. Here we go. Okay. You think these people care what you have to say? Look at them. They're so bored, half of them are falling asleep. I think I already said that. The other half are peeing in their pants because that's more exciting than listening to you. I can smell the asparagus. That's gross. I almost let myself go before I decided to come out here and shut you up. Gross. Let me stop you right there because I need to ask the WWE Universe a question. Do you guys want to continue listening to this bloated, overbearing, blowhard ramble on until you boom to death and leave in protest? I didn't think so. You know what? We're going to use our mic skill and just end this fool. I've had enough of your talking. Holy crap. Big clothesline from Puma. That was awesome. Get up. And right now, we're just going to put a beating on this fool. This is fantastic. Pile driver, center of the ring. And you know what, Hideo? We've all had enough of you. Especially me. Oh, into reversal. Oh, my gosh. Okay. He's kind of got the upper hand on us here. I'm not sure what it takes to win this. Maybe it's just similar to... Oh, look at this. Knees to the back. Driver. Oh, just taking him out. The ref having to hold us back.
Was this one ruled a no contest?
Uh-oh. We pushed him out of the way.
I don't know what it was.
Okay, that was quite interesting. Okay, so now that we've totally decimated Hideo Itami, let's get into our match here with Samoa Joe. Okay, making our way down. It doesn't look like we're getting stopped, so we're just going to skim through these entrances here. Okay. This dude's shirt. I got suplexed by Brock. Why would anybody want that? Okay, Samoa Joe, come on. After we just put a beating on Hideo Itami. Oh.
There's no other way to put it. This
no. I don't think so.
Sense of the word. Neither man looks like they are remotely entertaining the idea of backing down. This is going to be good.
Okay. Well, none of that worked, but we're going
to
send him across here.
And that's the way it should be.
Look at this.
Both these superstars.
Holy cow. That was pretty cool.
Real quick. You know, it's nights like
and now
this,
Samoa Joe's slowly getting to his
WWE
feet.
For more and more and more.
And big drop kick to the back.
Samoa Joe briefly.
And now the stomps.
Game face on tonight, and, better because
and
God,
a kick to the head. And another kick. No, he blocks it quickly at that. Holy cow, that's a pretty big move. Now, as I said in previous videos, we've had our struggles against Samoa Joe. He's a big dude who likes to go for those submissions, and we're just no good with submissions. And we're going to do the stomps, try to get him to use some of those signatures. I'm sorry, some of those reversals. And into a wheelbarrow bulldog. Very nice move. Hopping over, going up top. This might be too much too soon. But he doesn't reverse it, and CM Punk lands hard across the body and the chest. And I told you once, I've told you 1,000 times, Joe. I'm sick of it. I'm sick of you. And we get reversed. Of course we did. And, oh, nice. We did use up all our reversals, but it turns out it's okay since we use the major reversal. And we don't, and he can't reverse anything right now. So we're going to go up top and take care of this. Bam! Go for the pin.
Jeez,
off the 630. It may not work, but we're going to try to end this quick. And no. Of course, Samoa Joe's going
to
power out of it. Now, Samoa Joe, we're going to try to get a beating on him. Not what I wanted to do, but okay. We can do this here. Across the ring. Hurricane Rana right down on his face. Come on, stand up, Joe. Stand up, Joe, because I think we have a knee that needs to go right into your facial area. We take him down. Spin around. Oh, shoot, he reversed us. I was trying to flip him over. He drops us to the mat. No. Okay, we can kick out, I hope. Oh, man. So much kicking out happening. That was... Come on, Joe. Why didn't I scoot out of the ring? I can't reverse that suplex from that position, apparently. Samoa Joe flips us over. We got it. Uh-oh. I hope this isn't a submission. Okay. I guess I'd rather get kicked in the face.
Ah.
Damn, Sasha, what are you trying to do to me? Oh! That's what you get, you big dummy. That is what you get. So we're going to hop up here. We might miss. Oh, we got him. We have missed before. And look at this. We're going to call him up. Douche. Douche. That's what happens. Knee to the face. Knee to the face. And now, big vaulting, twisting, something or other to the outside. Joe's got
to
be done for. Joe's got to be done.
Oh, man, is he
okay, we're pointing at the ground at nothing.
And I think he's begging him to bring it.
Asking the crowd to get behind us here. Come on, Joe. Come on, Joe. Joe, come on. Each of these he's just standing around outside. Gets in here. Big clothesline to the back of the head. Stomp there, and we're going to pick him up. He's got all of his reversals, so this may not be good. And we get him in an uppercut. Very nice. Very nice. Let's put an end to the Samoan submission machine. Kick to the stomach. All the way across the ring. Jungle stomp to the head. Go for the pin. Can this end Samoa Joe? Does it? It does. It does. No longer do we have any problems with Samoa Joe, it seems, as we take care of business. That was a pretty quick match. Pretty quick match. All right, let's get into this next NXT main event. It's pay-per-view week. We should be facing off against Hideo Itami, but let's at the pay-per-view, but we'll see what's going on NXT. Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight. Shut up, Renee. Have you had a chance to play the new WWE video game? I hear you're in it. What the Renee? Yeah, I got it. I play it every day. Every kid dreams of being on a cereal box or being in a video game. It's an honor to be in that video game. I just wish they got my pretty face right, even though I'm wearing a mask. Looks a little off. How ridiculous. Okay, so here we are in the final week of October, where I am correct that it is pay-per-view week. So, let's take a look at the rankings real quick. Boy, Hideo, you're getting a lucky break. You moved all the way down to 8, and you're getting a shot at the NXT champion. T-shirt sales have gone down some, but still, holy cow. We are 26 rivalry points into with Hideo Itami, so, I mean, that's good. Oh, not Cactus Gage. So we have only one win. We've only faced Hideo one time. How ridiculous. But it's fine. We have 26 rival points, and it looks like we have a self-promotion promo, and then we face Hideo Itami again. Xander Snow in there facing Zack Ryder, Cactus Gage, and Gentleman Jack. So that's all going to be in the next video. And then after that, we'll get into the pay-per-view. And then regardless of what happens, whether we win or lose, we move on to the main roster where we take on, I guess we'll be putting at number 10 here for the Intercontinental Championship. But we will be moved up to the main roster and we will start our travels there as NXT champion and hopefully Intercontinental Championship. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Here we are, folks. It is pay-per-view week here in our My Career Mode. Come on back. Catch up.